Hello, my sweet sippers. Welcome to the Sweet Tea Blog, where the tea is so sweet. Today's topic is about the Salt-N-Pepa movie review, and I'm just going to cut to the chase. Let's go ahead and talk about what everybody's talking about, how Spinderella is pretty much not in the movie. Now, everybody is bashing Salt-N-Pepa, and everybody's saying that they're wrong, and I must say that in my personal opinion, I do agree. My sweet sippers, was Spinderella not in the group? Was she not the end for the Spinderella of Salt-N-Pepa? Spinderella was talented. She wasn't just a DJ in the back. She rapped, she danced, she shared the stage with them. She won the awards with them. She took the picture. She was on the red carpet. And I do recall Spinderella saying that she was treated as an independent contractor for all of these years. But even if she was an independent contractor, who was she an independent contractor for? Salt-N-Pepa. She, for her to have been an independent contractor, she sure was treated like she was very much so part of the group. So a lot of people are disappointed about this movie, but I must say I personally didn't get to watch all of it. My sweet sippers, I only saw bits and pieces of the movie. I only saw a little bit of the beginning, a tad bit of the middle, and I saw it near the end. Now, I will admit that from what I've been seeing on social media, people aren't happy with the review, not just because of DJ Spinderella not being in it as she should be, but also she was not in it. But also the reviews were not very good because people thought that the movie wasn't good for 3 hours. But anybody who remembers the great 90s era, you remember all three of Salt-N-Pepa. I mean, yes, at first it was Salt-N-Pepa, but once DJ Spinderella came in, I remember that Spinderella, the new addition to Salt-N-Pepa, was all that people talked about. Not talking about Spinderella is like not talking about Left Eye of TLC. Now, this is an article from Rolling Out that I did find. The morning after iconic DJ Spinderella, blah, blah, blah. You all created for yourself. And of course, Spinderella, also known as Deidre Muriel. I hope I said her name right. Muriel Roper. She had nothing to do with it. But of course, you could tell she had nothing to do with it because her character was barely in it. Now, I'm hoping that maybe VH1 or somebody would do a nice documentary or a nice, movie honoring DJ Spinderella. Sorry, but, you know, I know DJ Spinderella didn't rap on every song, but when she rapped, she laid down those tracks. And I'm going to show you all in just a second how your girl put down bars for days, especially on that hit with In Vogue. When they collaborated with In Vogue on that song, What a Man, did DJ Spinderella not have the best rap bar? Did she not have the best rap verse? Everybody knows to come in when Spinderella said, that's not it. Or when she would say, yes, it's me that he's always choosing. With him, I'm never losing. And he knows that my name is not Susan. Come on now. DJ Spinderella did her thing. She shared the stage with them. She shared awards with these women. And for her to be an independent contractor, I mean, if she was an independent contractor, she was very much so considered as part of the group. Now, here's what a lot of people have said. I wish Salt-N-Pepa realized that we love them, but we love Spinderella just as much. We respect her 30-year-plus contribution to SNP, even if they don't. Hashtag Salt-N-Pepa movie on Twitter. You know Black Twitter was not happy, my good people. And I see that a lot of people were not. Now, I did find that some of Salt-N-Pepa's personal struggles were quite interesting with Peppa's marriage to Track and Salt dealing with being bulimic. So that was interesting to know. But I still would have liked to see Spinderella in the movie. I mean, anytime you look up pictures of Salt-N-Pepa, you see the three of them. They were a trio and they were a group. And I would think that technically when there's a group, every and anybody's an independent contractor.
Never says he loves me not, mana rush me good and touch me in the right spot. See all the guys that I've had, they try to play all like Matt. But every time they tried, I said, that's not it. But not this man, he's got the right potion. Baby, rub it down and make it smooth like lotion. Yeah, the ritual, highway to heaven. From 7 He's got me open like 7-Eleven. And yes, it's me that he's always choosing. With him, I'm never losing. And he knows that my name is not Susan. He always has heavy conversation over mine, which means a lot to me, cause good men are hard to find.
And here's another article that says Spinderella said she was wrongfully excluded from Salt-N-Pepa biopic, expresses disappointment. I totally agree. And you all know you just heard that verse that I love on the What a Man collaboration with In Vogue. Come on now, just like that Twitterer said, Spinderella was and still is a bad bitch. Now, I remember that haircut. I remember the Daisy Dukes. I remember the sexy video of Salt-N-Pepa and In Vogue with What a Man. But come on now, Spinderella had bars. Give her flowers. Give her her props. And not only that, tell what really happened. Tell the story. If Spinderella was there, she was there. That's like being married to somebody and acting like you was never married to them. The marriage happened. You may have had a divorce, but the marriage happened. Y'all may not be cool anymore, but she was in that group. TLC, they had their disagreements. They had their issues. T-Boz and Chili had their issues with Left Eye. Unfortunately, not too long before Left Eye passed. But when they did their biopic with VH1, Left Eye was all in that movie. And even the problems that they had with Left Eye, as much as Left Eye wanted to go solo, Left Eye wanted to go solo 10 trillion times. But did she go solo? Yes, she did. But when TLC did a movie in her honor, in their honor of TLC, did they leave out the fact that she wanted to go solo? Did they leave the drama behind? Did they leave Left Eye behind? No. And yes, may Left Eye Lisa Lopez rest in heaven. And yes, Spinderella is not deceased. But at the end of the day, Spinderella was in that group. And let's not act like let's act like she was there. Let's not act like she wasn't there. Excuse me if I'm using improper grammar, my sweet sippers. I will say that from the bits and pieces that I saw of the movie, I thought it was okay. Again, I would have to see the whole thing to really have a true opinion on it. But just from what I did see, just seeing that Spinderella was pretty much not in it and the character barely had anything to say, I just don't think that was right. Now, again, if DJ Spinderella was an independent contractor, they very much so fooled everybody and probably fooled her because they were pretty much part of the group. But see, now here's where the legalities come in. Here's where the legal issues come in. Here's where this, that, and the third contract sign here comes in. Because see, now DJ Spinderella is saying that she either has already taken them to court or she will be taking them to court because she's owed so much money. And I would sue them too for lying. You're pretty much acting like I wasn't there. I was there. So I would be suing you. I was there. You're not going to act like I wasn't there. Okay? So, you know, I really hope that Spinderella gets her justice. I really hope that VH1 or BET does a nice, documentary or biopic for her, or gives her a nice justified interview. And then again, I hope that her and Salt-N-Pepa patch things up. Like, comment, share below, and subscribe below. Thank you for watching the Sweet Tea Blog, where the tea is so sweet. Hit that subscribe button. Toodaloo. Bye-bye.